his advisors. And I have to, it is not a political issue. And even if you don't vote Israel, even if Israel is not your main issue, you have to vote for free men. In any war between the civilized man and the savage, you must side with the civilized man, no matter how fancy the argument of the savage is. Yesterday, Tariq Ramadan endorsed Obama. Why is every enemy of America endorsing Obama? Why is every friend that he has an American hater and an Israel hater? The tide is going to change, ladies and gentlemen. I won't even go into the socialism. I'm not even going to go there. I will say that when he went to Hawaii, his mentor, his father figure, was Frank Marshall, a virulent anti-Semite, a virulent anti-American hater. The man was pressing on socialism. I mean, the mother met Lolo Saturo, met Barack Hussein Obama Sr. in a Russian language class. You know, this is decades ago. You know what was going on with the Russians. Bill Ayers. Bill Ayers, in his book, said Sirhan Sirhan was a victim of imperialism, that Jews were Zionist evil oppressors, that the Jews stole the land in imperialistic zeal. I don't know what case you can make for Obama. In the massive campaign for that I have documented, there are literally tens of millions of dollars coming in from overseas. There's an enormous, massive campaign. I mean, when you look at what we're up against, what McCain is up against, 4-1 in spending. So much fraud, it's overwhelming. So much voter fraud. You, believe it or not, you here in Florida, you got the world in your hands. You got some heavy burden. And I challenge you to research everything that I've said here. I challenge you to vote your conscience. I challenge you to vote for those 6 million that died, not for nothing. There's a tape, the LA Times has a tape of Obama at a dinner with Rashid Khalidi, a virulent anti-Semite, where he was being honored. Where there was a Palestinian dance troupe, and at the end of the dance troupe, they do mock beheadings. Where a poet came up to recite beautiful Jew-hating poetry. And where allegedly, according to a witness at the LA Times that saw the tape, he claimed that Obama made a speech that said that Israel was committing genocide against the Palestinians. They will not release the tape. Could you imagine if it was McCain and he had met with somebody at Ku Klux Klan, you know, couple there? Your tape would be running 24/7 on the news. They won't release the tape. And I challenge the Jews in Hollywood, Spielberg, who's documented every Shoah victim. You know about that, the Shoah, and they made a research department at the University of Southern California, and oh, isn't that gorgeous? Fetishizing dead Jews. Why doesn't he pull this entertainment advertising? And Geffen, and Miller, and Katzenberg, they put him there. Does anybody know the mother, any of these mothers, grandmothers, anybody can they won't release the tape. What is so devastating on that tape that they will not release that tape at that dinner? These are his friends. He says that Bill Ayers was a friend, a neighbor, that's what he says. He wrote a book review for his book. All right, I want to give the floor. I could go on. Oh, you don't know what I have. You're just getting a little cherries here. You're just getting a little bon mot. It devastates. Believe me, I've never done this before. I have four children. I love my life. I've never been politically involved. I'm just a regular girl. You can see my dress, I have a purse for a rat dress. This is not my thing. But I know, and I feel like Moshe Beadle in Elie Wiesel's Night, when he comes back to the town and he's screaming, that maniac, that... Let me tell you something, one quick, very funny story, and then I'm gonna give the floor to Nidra. With all that I've broken, all these stories that I've broken, I broke Odinga in Kenya, I won't go into his pal in Kenya that he raised money for, who signed a memorandum of understanding that if he seized power against our ally, Kibaku, our ally, he would institute Sharia. I broke that story, I broke the massive campaign, which is in my opinion, the biggest story of the campaign. Never got any press, never, nothing. The birth certificate being altered, there's a story there. He won't release the birth certificate. I'm not saying he wasn't born in America, I'm saying there's something on that birth certificate that he doesn't want you to see. You want to be president, I gotta present a birth certificate just to join, you know, certain clubs, but he's gonna be president. No. I want you to know that I got on TV for the first time. You ready? Keith Olbermann, the night before last, named me one of the worst people in the world. Bill O'Reilly was behind me, but I lost. I lost out to the number one worst person in the world. You know who that was? Sarah Palin. Sarah Palin was the worst. This is the one race I'm happy to lose, because I admire and respect her, and they've trashed her and made her into garbage. And she's a mother of five children, city council, PTA, mayor, governor, 85% approval rating, kicks ass, takes names. I'll take a human being with common sense, over any elitist from some Ivy League full of, you know what, university. I want you to hear Nitra Pollard. She's coming up next. She's a brilliant journalist. She writes for the Weekly Standard, the Wall Street Journal. She's an investigative journalist. You would never know about Ilan Halimi, the French Jew, who lived in a homemade concentration camp for 3 weeks in a building where they all heard his screaming, and they went in and took turns, cigarettes in his arms and acid, died in the street 3 weeks later. We would never have known about any of it if it wasn't for Nitra Pollard. I just want you to know that. They won't put that stuff on French TV. She's going to speak to you. She's an American, but she's an expat living in France since 1972, and I think that she will give you a different perspective on the election that I think you need to hear. Thank you so much for listening to me.
Can you all hear me?
Yes.
I was born in Jessup, Pennsylvania. You know Jessup, Pennsylvania? It's just around the corner from Scranton. 36 years ago today, I moved to Paris with my three teenage children. I probably knew more black people then than Obama. He was about 11, right? I was on the left. I was a third worlder. And the last thing I ever imagined was that I would be facing good old-fashioned Jew hatred. Old-fashioned Jew hatred in a new form. In a new form that people would not recognize, even though in the city of Paris, in my neighborhood, I live in the most beautiful neighborhood of Paris, the Marais, the old Jewish quarter, and you can go by and see the plaques dedicated to Jewish children who were taken from the schools and sent to the camps and exterminated. In those streets, and they'll still cry about the Shoah, you know that. You can get tears about the Shoah from anyone. And a new kind of Jew hatred with violence. Yes, Ilan Halimi, who was tortured to death in a Parisian banlieue. Sebastian Salam, who was beheaded in a 10th arrondissement public housing building by a neighbor, a Muslim neighbor, who said, "I killed my Jew." Rudy Haddad, who was beaten into a coma in the 19th arrondissement of Paris in August, and all the media came out and said, "Ah, this isn't anti-Semitism. This is conflict between rival gangs, the Jewish gangs and the Muslim African gangs." I broke that story. I have to correct something. I'm published by Commentary Magazine, the Wall Street Journal, City Journal, Atlas Shrugged, not by the Weekly Standard. I've been told they admire my writing, but I couldn't get any of my Obama articles in them. Okay, so I came to Paris, I was a novelist. In September 2000, 28th of September 2000, Ariel Sharon went to the Temple Mount. Do you know the name of the Temple Mount in French? Does anyone know? Anyone have the slightest idea? If you don't, you better get used to it, because if you don't do everything to be sure that Obama doesn't win,